Danny, this is Daniel over at AR Auto Service. I need you to give me a call back. I got some updates for you on the squareback. So give me a ring when you get this. Hey, Danny, Daniel over at AR Auto Service again. Hey, my technician just realized that we've got two different size tires here that you brought us. So give me a call as soon as you can, all right?
Hey guys, welcome to the final episode of Project Frankenwagon. So this isn't the final episode of this YouTube channel, This Old Jalopy. This is more like a series, or this is more like a season finale rather than a series finale. And at the end of this video, I'm gonna clue you in onto some big news for this channel and what's the future gonna be for this channel. And hint, hint, spoiler alert, there's gonna be some new projects. In this episode, I'm gonna be working on the suspension. I'm gonna be taking it to a high-end race shop to have it professionally aligned. And I'm gonna be getting the welder and the grinder out, and we're going to widen the fenders. All right, but before we can begin, I wanna give a shout out to another YouTube channel, and that channel is called Dream Wrench. And he's working on a really clean Volkswagen squareback right now. Like he's doing a restoration job like you're supposed to, like it's supposed to be done. But the reason why I'm giving a shout out to him and his channel is because he offered to send me some patch panels for to repair the rust in the front fender. However, the passenger side fender is so far gone, I'm not sure it's worth saving. So we might work something out, we might not, but hey, it's a really nice offer, so thank you, Pat. Shout out to you, man. Thank you. With that out of the way, let's roll the footage. Thank you. Alright guys, I'm finishing putting this Bilstein suspension in and removing that 3-inch lift kit that was in there. I was running these bigger tires and now I'm moving over to these smaller steel wheels that I like a lot better. And in the front, yeah, I replaced the old suspension and that 3-inch lift kit and replaced that with a Bilstein suspension from an NB Miata. And this was what was in there. Really crappy shocks. And additionally, in the front, the coil springs were cut to lower it an extra inch or an inch and a half. And so when you factor that in, when I removed that 3-inch lift kit, it wasn't like dropping it 3 inches. It was only dropping it like an inch or two. But in the back here, the coils weren't cut. And so it's going to be a lot closer to dropping it 3 inches, which is a lot. And I'm pretty worried that it's not going to fit at all. But I already have it in there and put it back on the ground and see what it looks like. Okay, this was the 3-inch lift kit. So it was like this bracket and the one side bolted into the lower control arm where the shocks would go. And then the other side bolted, that's what the shocks bolted to, and offsetting it 3 inches or so. No longer in there, getting that out of there. Okay guys, here goes nothing, I guess. Gonna lower it down here and see how bad it is. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to get my floor jack out of there now. Only fit about one finger in here, and so it's definitely gonna rub on some bumps, huh? All right, I'm about to start trimming the. About to start stretching this fender. Finally, I've waited a long time to finally do this, and I've decided that I'm gonna do pie cuts. And I looked at a lot of different ways to do this. And I could have like cut this way around the arch and then pulled the arch out and then welded some filler metal in there, but I don't think that would work as well because the problem is that it's hitting about there. This is able to extend past the wheel, but the wheel travels up, hits it about there. So the whole thing needs to come out a little bit. And what I'm gonna try and do is cut about here and here, pull this out, and then try and reconnect them with a nice smoothness to it. We'll see how it goes. Thank you. be a lot better. That's a lot of room now. Actually, overall, I'm pretty proud of it. I think it's pretty good. Now I just gotta do the other side. Two things I want to point out for you. Obviously the wheels are now black because I painted them. And the second thing is I want to show you why I was stressing out about all this, having all this clearance. Because the new tires are a lot taller. They're 1 inch taller. So the black looks good. I might do some white walls. I might do some hubcaps. You can see some more rust repair. And then tomorrow, these are going on. I'm having a shop that specializes in Miatas install these. And they're also going to do a full alignment front to back. And that's pretty important, I think. So that'll be nice. And I can't wait, and I'll bring you guys with me when I go there. So stay tuned. Guys, I'm at the alignment shop. They specialize in Miatas, and they're gonna get to work on it. And they're gonna have new tires, new alignment. Hopefully everything is good while I'm leaving. All right, see you guys soon.
Danny, this is Daniel over at AR Auto Service. I need you to give me a call back. I got some updates for you on the square back. So give me a ring when you get this. Hey, Danny, Daniel over at AR Auto Service again. Hey, my technician just realized that we've got two different size tires here that you brought us. You've got some Westlakes that appear to be a 70 series, and then some Hankooks that appear to be 75s. We're curious as to whether or not you did that on purpose and which ones you wanted where. So give me a call as soon as you can. All right.
My car next to a Ferrari. That's freaking cool. I just drove back from the mechanic, those guys that did the alignment, and the drive down here was really nice. I'm amazed at like the quality difference. Number one, in the how much quieter and softer these tires feel. Those old tires were just really harsh. And number two, it just has a better feeling now with the driving because of the alignment. But I also really want to say that when I was picking up the car, those guys all came out to talk to me, and they all had a lot of good things to say about the car. They really liked it. And I thought that was so cool because those guys work on Porsches and Ferraris and luxury German cars and Italian cars all day long. And I thought it was really cool that they liked my car. They said they had the funnest time working on my car today. But they didn't get the white wall tire inserts installed, those portal wall inserts. They tried for like over half an hour to get one of them on, and they gave up. And I said, that's fine, because I'm not married to the idea anyways. So let's take a look at it. That was kind of crazy. In the shop and just got done driving home. Very happy with the way it's turned out. Did you hear that? Did you hear that? That was a big boom. Big boom. Okay, so very happy with the way these tires have turned out. They feel great on the road. And they look good. They're the right size, I think. I'm very happy with the size. What I'm gonna do is see if I can't install some hubcaps like this. These are 9-inch chrome dome hubcaps made for semi-trucks. They fit these Miata wheels real nicely. 9 inches. If you have the 15-inch steelies, you might want the 10-inch hubcaps. So I guess that'll do it for this episode. Thanks for watching, guys. Let me talk a little bit. So this is gonna really be the last full feature episode for this build.
Actually, I have a lot of news for the channel. So, let me first say that, yeah, this is gonna be the last episode because this car project is almost done. This is my to-do list, so not much left. And it's overall been a success. It's been a real success, and that was verified today by the guys at the mechanics at that shop. Let me know they really liked this build. And here's the big news, though. This project is going to be done, but there's several new projects in the works, in the pipelines, and that is because I bought a house. The house does not have a garage, so I'm going to build a garage. And what do you need if you're going to build your own garage? You need a pickup truck. So I'm going to be getting an old crusty pickup truck and building a garage, and I'm going to have both those projects on this YouTube channel, and because I want this channel to grow. So if you want to watch those projects, then subscribe. Hit that subscribe button, hit that like button, leave me some comments. I'm going to put one more video together, and what that's going to be is that's going to be like a montage of the build from all the way from the start to this finished product here. And do you remember my yellow Super Beetle? Yeah, so the way it started was it was going to be this Miata and a yellow Super Beetle. Instead, I got the square back, which I'm very happy with that decision. It's going to be fun to stroll through those that old footage and put together like a little montage of the whole build. So stay tuned for that, guys, and thank you for watching. And on that bombshell, peace out.